Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, the Most Beneficent, the Most Merciful. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May mercy, peace, and blessings of Allah be upon all of you, sisters and brothers. Welcome to this presentation covering the basic details of the life after death, that is barzakh, or the purgatory in the light of Islamic traditions, exclusively from the Shia ithna-ashri point of view. What is it like being dead? Is there anything beyond this life? Were we just meant and created for this world and would cease to exist once we die? Of course, these questions have bubbled in your minds, just like how they cluster mine at times. So let us look at the 101 of this topic and endeavor to understand the main fragments of this topic of afterlife. Of course, we don't have people coming back from the dead to tell us the tale of what does and what does not exist after life. But alhamdulillah, we do have reliable sources that guide us on this and help us prepare for this life to come. So what is this gap that is between us starting from the time of our death and the Day of Judgment? We learn from the Quran and traditions of the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam that death is not the end of man, but in fact is just the beginning of his accountability for his deeds committed during his lifetime. After death, the soul of a person enters the world of barzakh or the purgatory and continues its life there until the Day of Judgment. The barzakh should not be confused with the transmigration of souls, wherein a soul following death enters the body of an animal or a different human being and continues its life in that manner until it is purified of its sins. This concept does not parallel with any of the principles of Islam and hence is disregarded in its entirety. Interestingly, the great philosopher and scholar, as you would all be aware of, Mullah Sadr, explains that the soul of the body in this world itself has a barzakhi form, which the man takes with him or her from this life to the world of barzakh after his death. Let us look at what Allah has to say about this in the Holy Quran. The Holy Quran has called this gap a barrier in Surah 23, verse 100. If we examine this verse closely, it shows us clearly that there is something that separates us from the Day of Judgment for some time at least after we die. Have a read. We could compare the world of barzakh to the world of dreams and know that the Almighty Allah has made the dreams and whatever is seen in these dreams as examples of barzakh, so that the imagination of the world of barzakh becomes possible for us to conceptualize, even though the world of barzakh with regard to this world is like waking up is to sleeping. As per traditions, we know that there are three groups in barzakh. First is of the true perfect believers, second of the confirmed unbelievers and hypocrites, and third of those who are neither perfect believers nor confirmed unbelievers. So we, a majority of us, may fall in this third bracket. These levels are determined by the questioning in the grave about Allah and Islam done by the two angels everyone is aware of, Munkir and Nakir, on the night of one's burial. Depending on the answers, if the individual is successful, the angels Mubashir and Bashir would come to congratulate the individual, inshallah you and me, one day, and his journey through the levels of barzakh would be made easy, inshallah. His ultimate abode then would be Wadi As-Salam in Najaf, which is the valley of peace for the good souls. The unsuccessful souls, on the other hand, would find crossing the barzakh endless, tiring, and agonizing, with tormenting punishments for different categories of sins, such as backbiting, fornication, lying, ignorance, wastage of resources, extravagance, amongst many other sins. These would reside in Wadi al-Barhut, that is the Valley of Troubles, which is said to be in Yemen. Following this questioning and this endless tiring procedure of Munkir and Nakir, the soul's squeezing in the grave is inevitable for us normal individuals as part of the soul purification process. The ones undergoing this questioning would also undergo the squeezing of the grave, and logically there would be a positive correlation between the two. That means that the greater the sins, the greater the painful squeezing of the souls, and vice versa. The punishments of barzakh are difficult to such an extent that Imam Ja'far Sadiq alayhi salam has himself said that he is worried about us for the period when we would be in barzakh. If following the painful squeezing that I mentioned earlier, there are still some sort of sins remaining within the soul would be made to cross several extremely nerve-wracking levels or phases where the soul's performance and help available to it in Barzakh would solely be dependent on how his life, his or her life, was prior to their death. For instance, where a person has a correct belief, had a correct belief, and committed good deeds, these actions would take a form of a human being and come for his assistance as his companion on this long journey, something that we all would definitely need and look forward to. Whereas for a person with kufr, signs or extravagance, and a lot of sins that have not been forgiven by Allah, these would come in the shape of an evil man ready to misguide and hurt you and harm you. As you can see from this quote of Imam Khomeini, he is quoted to have said that there is a supernatural and unseen form for every deed, whether good or bad, in the celestial world and the unseen sphere. This shows us how, whether we realize it or not, the words that come out of our mouths or the deeds that take form from our limbs take a metaphysical or transcendental form, which are unseen and cannot be seen in this world, but can be seen in the next. While the person in Barzakh would have lost his chance to repent and his book of deeds would have been closed, as per traditions, the merciful Allah still leaves a link between the living world and the person who has passed away, which is in the form of sadqa jariya, or the perpetual charity through which the individual who has passed away can improve his or her condition in Barzakh. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said that when a believer dies, nothing from his deeds is left except three things: the charity left behind by him which continues after his death, i.e. sadqa jariya, a knowledge taught by him from which people are still benefiting, and a righteous son or a child who prays for him. Examples of the sadqa jariya, or perpetual charity, can be considered as the pious actions of his family or relatives in the name of the one in Barzakh, or a good deed done by the person himself while he was alive, which is still benefiting people in some sort of way. For example, he had taught someone something good or had done a useful act, such as building an orphanage, school, water well for the poor. He had spread the message of Islam through websites or programs, etc. These would all come to the person's aid while he's in Barzakh and even continually ease, if not erase, the torment befalling that soul. Therefore, while we may not realize the extreme importance and value this holds for the one in Barzakh or our relatives who have passed away, it is very useful and important for the souls of our relatives that we remember them and dedicate, at least take out some time in a week to dedicate Surah Fatiha recitations for them as much as possible, as now this is the only link that is left between the living world and their souls, which can still benefit them and ease in their pains in some sort of way until the advent of the Day of Judgment. Inshallah, may Allah guide our souls in this world and assist us in advancing towards the path of piety, love, and obedience towards Allah, and help us in keeping away from sins which would destroy us in our life to come, especially our life in Barzakh. Ya Allah, we beg you to ease our punishment in our graves and to make the squeezing of our graves as that of a hug of a friend, inshallah. Ya Arhamar Rahimeen, please have mercy on our souls, inshallah, and accept our efforts in your path and the path of your appointed lights on earth. Sadaqallahu al-Azim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.